I'm Benton from the Witcher 3 REDkit team, and I'm going to show you around today how to install and use mods for the Witcher 3. This is unrelated to the REDkit, but we would like to show for people who want to use mods, not make mods, on how to get started with everything. All right, so let's begin. First of all, make sure that for the first version, for Steam Workshop to work, you have to have the game on Steam, because as usual, naturally, Steam Workshop only works on Steam. So for this, you have to have the latest update for the game, and then go to the community tab of the game, where you will be able to browse mods created by others. So for example, I can go to this mod with this cat, which is actually made by me. And you just click on subscribe, and then Steam will start updating the game. And once this is complete, you can just launch The Witcher 3, and you will have everything in your game setup. If you want to uninstall something, you can just unsubscribe, and that's it. You don't have to do anything else. It is fairly simple, and I think many of you will appreciate it. The other way that you can go about this is manually installing mods or using some mod manager. So for this to happen, I'm gonna go to the installation folder of Witcher 3. So in this folder, there is this folder called mods. This will not be here by default, so you have to hand create it. And then here, for each of your mods, you have to create a new folder without spaces or anything crazy. And inside here, you will have the actual content of your mod. So for example, the best place to get Witcher 3 mods currently is to go to Nexus Mods, then navigate to the Witcher 3. And for example, that is amazing mod, created by one of the quest designers at CD Projekt, Philip Weber, who worked on The Witcher 3 originally, and he created a new mod to have a different feel to the fantasy world in the game. So what you have to do is go to the files, download it with either the manager or manually. And as you can see, if I preview the content, it has the same structure as I was showing to you. So once you have this downloaded, you can extract it to this folder, and once you load the game, everything should be working without issues. And it's as simple as that. Thank you.